Okay, can.
Okay, so, with that, right? You have two times chest over two is chest, okay, ma? Okay? Two times five will give you?
Ten.
And then, zero times two will give you?
Zero.
Okay. After that, what do I do next?
Move the ten.
Move the ten over. Oh, and the action of moving the ten, what am I actually doing? Pierce.
Oh.
Pierce. Come, redeem yourself. Last time I thought you gave me the funny answer. Now I'll try. How do I bring the 10 over? What do I do to both sides?
Separate.
If I want to bring the 10 over to the right, what do I do?
Minus 10 on?
Minus 10 on? On both sides. Okay, minus 10 on both sides. Okay, ma? Can ah? Very good. Thank you, yes. Okay, so minus 10. So 10 minus 10 will give you? 0, 10 off. Okay, mom, 10 off. I try not to say, okay, I know I like to say this, bring 10 over, bring 2 over. I will not use it, but because the action is you need to know what's the bring. So I just say the both sides. So this gx equals to minus 10, and x equals to minus 10 over 3. Okay? Can, yes. Sorry, what did I do? Gx times 2. Because of the denominator, when I take 3x over 2, when I take 2, multiply by 3x over 2, right? Sorry, come on. Okay. Can you see 2 multiplied by 3x over 2? It will not give me 6x. What it will do is, it will cancel off. The 2 and the 2 will cancel off. If you are getting 6x, okay, I mean, you can also say this one. If I take 2 multiply by 3x over 2, you can say that, well, it's just a numerator and numerator, which is 6x, the denominator 2, cancel off, it's still 3x. It's still 3. Okay, ma, it's still equals to 3. Yes?
So is it because like 3x is being divided by 2, so if it times 2, then it gets 3?
Correct. Okay, all, can all. Yeah, okay, so never mind, it's okay. Yes.
Why is
3.2c
minus 1?
Why is 3.2c? Let me get to that. Let me finish this first. Okay, so this one, okay, what is wrong with this? Let's see, I'm not sure what happened.
Wrong method. I got wrong method. I didn't understand this.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Okay, so you must remember this 3 is related by times. Okay, can ah?
Can ah?
Okay. So this one I think I covered. Okay, let's say look at this one. Whose is this? Okay. Which one? Okay, so here the mistake is this. When you multiply by 2, right? I think what you did is you multiply by 2 on both sides. You didn't multiply the 5. Okay, okay, now good. Okay, so good. Okay, so next one. Same for this guy. Who's this guy? Also they have multiplied the 5. Correct, you realize you times 2, but here you times 2 only for this, you cannot times for this. Okay, ma, can I? You must remember multiply for the whole thing. When you multiply, you must be multiplying the whole thing like that. Okay, ma? Yeah, yes. No need. Okay, good question. If you have improper fraction, try to leave it improper. It's okay one. Okay, so this guy say, you see, notice times 2 but never times the 5. Okay, what number is that? This one. Same thing. Wow, this one 0 become 10. 0 become 10. Wow, bagus. Okay, yeah. Bagus then Mampos. Okay, so anyway, this one times. Okay, so this one, if you take 3x over 2 to 6x, right, you're actually multiplying by 4. You realize? If you want to go from 3x over 2, you notice that if you want to go from 3x over 2, when you take 3x over 2, you must be clear, when you take 3x over 2, and when you multiply by the number 2, what does the 2 do? It goes to the numerator or denominator?
Denominator.
I ask Sing Kai.
Sing Kai.
So two goes to the numerator or denominator? These two. Numerator, huh? Very good. Okay. But you can also cancel out like that. Okay, Mark, that's why you get three. That's why, I mean, if I have, for example, you know, if x is divided by 3 equals to 5, when you want to get rid of the 3, what do? You multiply by? Multiply by 3. Okay, Mark? So if there's a 7x equals to 28, when you want to get rid of the 7x, what do? You divide both sides by 7. Okay, Mark? You reverse times with divide. You reverse divide with times. You reverse minus with plus. You reverse plus with minus. Clear? Clear.
What is 4.1?
I get to that. Give me a while. Yeah, I get too fast. Because if I jump, then the rest will confuse. Okay, Mark, can I? Okay, so don't mind. Just give me a while. Okay. Okay, let me see. 3.1C. Is C okay for you? Oh, who got C wrong? On the screen, on the board, on the board. Cannot see, ah? Cannot see. How small, ah? It's coming soon to theater stage. 1, 2,
3.
Okay, nothing happened. Okay, so.
I use wrong method.
Okay, so.
I use wrong method. I'm very confused.
Hamza, your algebra is. Hamza, your algebra has cancer, you know. You must see. Very dangerous. Your algebra for stage 4 cancer. Better come see. Okay, first of all, this one. This is carefully. Okay, Hamza, your this guy, right? Okay, when you have a fraction, right, you cannot split the fraction. When you have 7 over 2 plus 3. Can I say that 7 over 2 plus 3, guys, is this the same as 7 over 2 plus 7 over 3? Okay, can you see it? Cannot. So see, if you look at yours, right? If you look at yours, okay, see the 2x and the minus 3? We cannot split the denominator. Okay, we can split numerator, but we cannot split denominator. So of course, on the other hand, if I have 2 plus 3 over 7, I can say that this is 2 over 7 plus 3 over 7. In fractions, we can split the numerator, but not the denominator. Okay, ma? So just be careful of how you deal with the fractions here. Okay? Okay, so for this student, can anyone tell me where's, can anyone pinpoint where's the small error? Anyone able to find?
Yeah.
Thank you. Wow, that burger. Wow. So, I want to know. Enthusiasm. So you can see that when you take 4, it's not showing up, don't know why. When you take 4, the 4 must go to the 2x and the 4 must go to the 3. Okay, ma?
Yeah.
So it has to be 4. 4 must multiply to 2x minus 3. Okay? So this is supposed to give you 8x minus 12. This is supposed to be a minus 12. Okay, ma? Can ma? So it's a very small thing. I just need to take note. This guy is a 12.
But this is the correct method, it's just that he didn't multiply.
Yes, this is the correct method. Okay, ma? Yes. Okay. Anyone else got this wrong? Can I explain again? Okay, so this one, okay, you see, if you which part is bothering you? Are you able to start? Or you got it wrong?
This one.
You don't know how to do. Okay. Okay, so this one, right? Help me to understand which part you are if you are bored. Okay. 2x minus 3, right? Equals to 4. I can write the 4 as 4 over 1.
Can I?
Okay, so thank you. Okay, see what I say. So you want to do something what we call cross multiply. You want to do something called cross multiply. Okay, so when you do cross multiply, remember in last week lesson, I said that if you cross multiply, it means something like that. When you have two terms are a over b equals to c over d. This means that a multiplied by d is equals to b multiplied by c. Okay? This means that a multiplied by d is equals to b multiplied by c. Is that okay? Can not. So a times d cross. It's like tying a shoelace equals to b times c. Like that. Is that okay? Can? Pula okay? No, not okay? Not okay. Not okay. Which part are you not okay with? The cross. Okay, so if you see, imagine that, okay. One more time, I explain the cross multiply on Monday's lesson. If you are not sure, you can go to my YouTube channel. You just watch the cross multiply part, Monday's lesson. Okay, after Monday's lesson, if you forgot. So, cross multiply is like that. When you have A over B equals to C over D, what does this imply? It means that A times D is equals to B times C. How does this work? Okay, this is what we call a heuristic. Okay, ma? So it requires no understanding. But why does this work? Okay, so if you remember, we did this that day. If we take example here. Is this still recording? Still recording. Okay, so for example, if I take X over 2 equals to, say, X plus 1 over 3. Okay, so Mulan, I have a 2 and I have a 3, right? Okay, so what do I need to do? Or maybe I just put 5 over 3. Really simple. Okay, how do I get rid of the 2? I times 2, okay, good. Okay, so I just need to put maybe 2x plus 1. Okay, how do I get rid of the 3? Okay, if I want to get rid of 2 and I want to get rid of 3, what do I need to multiply by? Do you see a number 6? Okay. How is 6 related to these two numbers? Okay, so you notice that here and here, you need to multiply by the LCM of 2 and 3. Is that correct? So you notice that here, I multiply by 6. Is that okay? Stay with me, especially if you're lost, stay with me. Yeah? Okay, so over here, 6 goes to the numerator. What is 6 divided by 2? 3. Okay, so you can see 6 divided by 2 gives me 3. Over here, 6 divided by 3 gives me 2. Okay, so it gives me 2. Okay, so this guy cancels off. No more, right? So what do you have is you have 3x equals 2 bracket 2x plus 1. Is that okay? Can you see that from my original question, right? How I got from here to here is as though I took this guy multiplied by this guy. Can you see? Sorry? How's that 3x equals to 4? So after, are you okay? Are you okay? Not okay. Give me a while, give me a while. Okay, so listen again, okay, Mulan. Can I see that I have a 2, this is like 2 multiplied to 2x plus 1? Can, so in a way, it's like a cross multiply. Can you see the green here, the blue is here? And the mechanics behind this is that I multiply by LCM. That's why this is true. That's why this is true. Okay, ma? Can I? So if you didn't catch this on Monday, you probably will have some difficulty solving your example 3.1, 3.2. Okay, ma? So make sure you know how to do the cross multiplication. Okay? Can I? Yes. Then you can. Okay, decimal, it must be non terminating. It must be non terminating. Yeah. Example like pi. You're fast. So, what you do is, okay, those who are fast, right, while waiting for me, you can do part 4, part 5. Don't hesitate, just go. 4.4. Okay, maybe for me. Oh, do your practice sets while waiting for me. Yes. Okay. Okay, so Mulan, this one okay? Mulan, quick one. Mulan, x over 2 equals to y over 3. Can you tell me the next line? Sorry, is that one? Can you tell me the next line? Go from here to get straight away. 6. 3x equal to 1, correct. Okay, can I? Yeah, okay. So, guys, all okay with cross multiply? Feels okay? Max okay? Max okay? Can I? All okay? Okay, make sure you are comfortable with this pattern. Yes. C, huh?
D.
Okay, I'll get to that. Can I? Yeah. So with that, I go to D. Okay. Let me go to D. D is this, right? Can I just check? Okay. So D, 3.1 D. You have the, who got D wrong? This answer is minus 18. Who got D wrong? 1, 2, 3. Okay, 4, 5. What? You have y minus 3 over y plus 4 equals to 3 over 2. Am I right? Is that okay? Can I? Okay, so from here, what's my next step? What do I do? You see a fraction equals to a fraction, and what do? Y minus 3 times? Very good. Okay, so just think of. When you take 1 minus 3 multiplied by 2, you are taking the whole bracket, multiply them together. This is what you are doing. Okay, ma? You are taking the whole y plus 4 and multiply it by 3. Okay? Which is why, if just now you have mistakes, you probably also will get mistakes for it. So this is 3 multiplied by y plus 4 equals to 2 multiplied by y minus 3. Is that okay? Okay? Okay, let me try. Hamza, if I simplify this, what will I get?
3y plus
12. Very good, 3y plus 12. Okay, so guys, 3 to y, 3y, 3 to 4 plus 12. 2 to y, 2y, 2 to minus 3, minus 6. Is that okay? Mm-hmm. Are you all good with this one? Can I? All good, okay. So with that, Okay? What I want to do is, if I'm solving for y, you know, you see at your own place. Okay.
So mean.
Okay, so from here, 3y, 2y, okay. So the thing is, guys, how do I put the y together? Are you all with me? Okay, look at me for a while. How do I put the y together? Do I take minus 2y on both sides or I minus 3y on both sides?
Minus 2y.
Minus 2y. Why don't minus 3y?
It's easier. You don't have a negative.
Ah, okay, very good. So my tip is this. Okay, when there are two guys, right, the smaller guy will go to the bigger guy. Because it keeps things positive. So what I do is, guys, you see, okay. I just want you to follow me. If you feel what I'm saying, if you can feel me, you know that if I'm minus 2y instead of minus 3y, I can have I remain a positive 1. But if I'm minus 3y, then I get a negative 1. So it's a bit disgusting to solve. Okay? Humans, when we do fraction, when we do numbers, we like small numbers, we don't like fraction. We like positive, we don't like negative. Okay, huh? So it's like that. Okay, so y plus 12 equals to negative 6. After that, what do I do to both sides? The person I want to ask is Kelly. From here, what do I do next to make y the subject? Minus 12 on both sides. Maxine, you got a question? You raise hand. You want to answer? Okay. And paper, I give you a chance to answer. Okay. So plus 12 minus 12 cancel off. Minus 6 minus 12 will give you negative 18. Okay, so your y is equals to negative 18. Is that okay? Can I? So y is equals to negative 18. Hey, what's happening? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Can I? Your y is equals to negative 18. Can? Yes. Go ahead. Can I? So this is how you do. Okay, I mean if you look at the question has its own techniques. Okay. Okay, yes. You also want to go. Wow, you Mulan, go with her. Mulan bring her along. Carry her. Okay. Because she's early
agent.
Okay. Try to go before the lesson now, so it's not so disruptive. Okay, 3.2. 3.2 the answers are 5 over 6, negative 5 over 7, negative 1. Who has problem with 3.2? 1, 2, 3. Can I just go around and take some photos? Okay. 3.2. 3.2A?
No.
Don't have. 3.2A. 3.2A. Okay. 3.2A? Any more? 3.2B? 3.2B. 3.2B.
No,
I see.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Isn't it 3 over? Isn't it 3 over? Oh, cannot be minus 1. If it's minus 1, right, the denominator becomes 0. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Give me a chair. I said it's 1, not minus 1. I said it's 1.
Yeah,
yeah.
Sorry.
I said it's one. Okay, so I just check. Okay, A. Thank you for being so open. Okay, so. Okay. A. Just check. A answer is supposed to be 5 and 5 over 6.
Yeah.
Can you read the 2 over x plus 1 equals to 3
over x plus 2? 2 over x plus
1, 2 over x plus 2.
Yeah, because
if you
read the
3
over x
plus 2
equals to plus
0
over x plus
2. Yeah, there's a hang. It's going
to be slow.
Okay.
What happened to the other
app? Oh, there are 2. Okay. Okay, I'm not too sure, sorry, I didn't catch it again.
Yeah,
so
can I bring the 3 over x plus 2 to the 0? That means 2 over x plus 1 equals to 3 over x plus 2.
2 over x plus 1 equals, yes, can. Then you cross multiply. Okay, I'll do the same. Okay, so okay, 3.2a, I just go here. Okay, so 3.2a. Let me just check out. Wow, who did this? Okay. Let me go through 3.2a. One. Not negative one. Yeah. Okay, let me go through this. There's a mistake. This one should be 4. Yeah. And my screen just nice hang here, cannot change. Okay. Answer is 1. Okay guys, the answer is here. You all know this. Someone keep asking, I heard, what's the answer 5, 6 times. You all saw this part. Okay, I just want to highlight this to you. Guys, what's the answer? Here. Guys, what's the answer? Here. Where's the answer? Here. One more time, somebody ask the answer, where's the answer? I will take a thought this and I will talk in your head.
Yeah. Why
thought
this? The
poor thought
this.
Oh, see how
you bully the
poor thought this. Why have we thought this? Okay, I don't know. Okay, anyway, next 3.2a. Okay, 3.2a. yeah, okay, so that's the thing. Yeah, okay. Okay. 3.2a, you have 5 over 2. Okay. 5 over 7 y plus 2 equals to 1 half over 2 y plus 3 quarter. So the 3 quarter, I put it as 13 over 4. The half over 2, okay guys, can you just see how I do it? I just want to see, I just show you one way, you see whether you buy or not. Okay, personally, what I like to do is I like to make a fraction equals to fraction. Okay, what I like to do is I like to have one fraction equals to another fraction. So this is what I call, the method is like what I call packing. Okay. So I'll pack them together. After that, I cross multiply. Okay, now generally I like to do this. So I like to pack into one fraction before I cross multiply. That's still okay, man? So you like what? Going to retire and all folks already. Okay, so jump for me. Or you while we go to sleep. Okay, so. Anyway, next. Okay, so 5. Here, 2. Okay. Can I say that this is 5 over 7 plus 2 over 1? Jing Kai okay? Maxine okay? Musha? Adina? Sabrina? Can I say it? Can I? Mulan? Tanya? Is it okay that I write this as this? Is it okay? Charmaine? Le Yi? Can I Kelvin? Pierce? Tan Hong Kai? Natalie? Venus? Is it okay that I write this as this? Are you with me? Or are you with that? Has your brain passed out already? Okay, yeah? Yeah, okay, is it okay I write this as this? Okay, so look carefully. 7 and 1, can I add them together? I can? Can this? I throw the marker at you. Okay. Can I add the marker to... Can I add the marker? Can I add the fraction together? Not here. What the fraction must I do? The denominator must be the same. Okay, so what do I need to do to this? Are they okay, ma? Are they okay? Good, Kunshun okay ma? Slash you, Kunshun. I call your sister here and slap you. Okay, so, is it, that okay ah? Cannot. You need to type 7/7. 7/7, correct ah? Can ah? Your mother is a primary school teacher, right? Then I call her here and she'll tell you, why Kunshun, you don't know how to do fraction. Okay, so, 2/7, this is 14. Can I say this is 14? So this one has become 7. This is 14/7. 5y/7, is it okay? Can I say that my left hand side is 5y plus 14/7? Okay ma? So when we want to interact with our neighbors, first you have to tidy up yourself. Your room and your house must be neat. So the right hand side also the same. I pack it into one fraction. Okay ah? This is 5/2 plus 13/4. Okay. Someone asked, and I want to say again, this question was asked 2 times today. Is it better to leave your answer in mixed number or improper? My answer to you, improper. Okay? Is it better to leave?
Huh?
Yeah, but I mean, because I want to show you a variety. Both are correct. But the preference, if you're working, right, you use improper. Okay, ma? Okay, so you can see, 3 1/4, I wrote it like that. Because for this, right, it's easy for you to convert one fraction. Yes, okay. Yes.
But in Excel,
it gives
the proper
fraction. So this is allowing for it. It's MJC. Okay, in mainstream syllabus, mainstream school, why is your basketball so lousy? You cannot aim, that's why all the toilet bowls so dirty. Okay, so joking. Oh, dear, it's going to be on screen. Okay, so 13/4. Okay, guys, this is proper. In mainstream school, for example, if you go tuition center or so ever, they will tell you. O-level, E-Max syllabus, they want the answers as mixed number. For us, no need. Okay, so you learn to filter. You don't everything your tuition teacher tell you, you just take. You must follow what the school teacher tell you, okay? 2 and 4, can I add?
No.
The more you look down, the more I ask you.
What?
2 and 4, can I add?
No.
Okay, so what do I do? Tuition, what do I do here? Redeem yourself, huh? Did not learn right to go. Numerator no need. Need. Okay. Okay. So this one is not multiplying both sides. I'm just simplifying this. This is 2y plus 13/4. Is that okay? Do you buy this part? Mula okay? Okay, ma? Can If you don't understand, it's because you suddenly lost your part. Mula, pay attention. Okay, so here you have 2y plus 3/4. So guys, now I have one fraction equals to another fraction. Can you see? I just want you to appreciate this is from a disgusting, you know, series of terms. I packed it nicely. Oh, thank you. Lucky for someone there. Okay, so I packed it into two beautiful fractions. So what do I do next? Max, what do I do next? Come on, Max, teach me some Max. What do I do next? Multiply. So what's my next step? 4 bracket? 5y plus 14 equal? Kelvin, next step. What's the next step, right hand side? Very good. Okay, Ken Mark? Pierce okay? Hamza? Mania? Ulan? Yulia? Tamalingam? Okay, ma'am. Okay, this part? I stress again, who say I lame? You say I lame?
No, he said if
she knows.
I got two legs, I said, huh?
He said if she knows.
If I'm lame, I will follow your surname. Okay, anyway, next. So.
No,
the name
is the same. That doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make sense, makes dollars. Okay, so. 451 plus 14, 721. So what I do is from here, okay, now, you know what to do next? You want to do next? Can I? So you just extend the bracket. But I want you to focus on this portion. Where I make it into one fraction equals to one fraction. Okay, ma? Okay, ma, guys? This is different from the textbooks or the working that you see here. I think the working you see here, they do something else. They ask you to, you know, it's a bit confusing. It's a bit confusing. Okay, so what I do is I just put one fraction. And they use the answer as fixed number. That's why I didn't show you the answer. I just want you to look at this and see that, you know, guys, you can actually solve it quite easily. From here, if you still don't know, anyone, do you need me to continue from here?
No.
No need. Okay, so. Okay. So this guy, who's working is this? Let me check. Yeah, who's this? Yours, okay.
No, it's not.
Check. This one, huh?
Yeah.
So from here, you multiply by 3 to get this one. You multiply by 3 over 3, lah. Here, you multiply by 2 over 2. How do you get from here to here? You multiply both sides by 6, huh? Right now, not minus 2z, right? Then you minus 2z, minus 2z, minus 8. Okay, looks weird, huh? First, you multiply by 2 over 2. Can anyone tell me what's the mistake for this? Can anyone tell me the mistake for this? Can you all be my teachers? Tell me where is there a mistake for this? It's correct, huh? Or B is correct, huh? Yeah, it's correct. Okay, no wonder. I'm gonna find a mistake. Okay, so this is B. Okay. Anyone need help with B? Anyone got B wrong? Anyone got B wrong? Thumbs up. Okay. Don't worry, it's okay. But you don't like it. Sometimes it's not a bad thing. The more you are ashamed, right? The more you will push yourself. Okay. Who is a B? Who? Yeah. Ask me later after class. Let me finish it. Anymore? Anyone got 3.2 wrong? Is it because your high sales check? Think high. Okay, ma, 3.2b. She's 3.2b, okay? This is question 3.2b. Is it okay? Yes, okay, okay, so can I go on? You better pay attention, okay, because I'm very sharp. When you are not looking at me or dozing off, I'll call your name immediately. And it's recorded, so your parents will see. Pierce. Guys, I say hi, that's Pierce. That's Pierce and he always hopping to girls after. Okay, anyway, next.
Okay,
what's wrong with this?
Let me see. Oh wait, no, it's mine. I use one
method. Same. Okay, you see, your fraction. This is not this. Okay, on this one, just be careful. 3z and minus 1. They are related by a negative sign. They are not related by multiplication. Okay. Yeah. So. Okay. My take is this. You're probably learning something else now. maybe during math tuition or something, they got confused. So this one is it's another topic.
Yeah.
Okay, you get B wrong. You got 5 out of 7. Did you get something like this? Okay, so this is another method. This is one of your students' one. Okay, so you got this, right? You got this, right? Actually, you are there already. Okay, let me tell you the difference between this and this. It's 1 mark. It's 1 mark. You have to make Zach the subject. Sometimes when you are, you know, like a bit behind, it's only because you just forgot a little thing. It's just that you buy the birthday cake, you never light the candle, that's all. Okay? Can I? So remember, make that a subject. Divide both sides by negative 1. Yeah, yes. It's correct, huh? It's correct, it's negative 5 of 7. It's your negative sign, you forgot. Oh, come on, Kaylee. Your negative sign looks like a full stop. I think you got a con by your own writing. Can I? All good? All good, huh? Okay. It's your B, okay? Hey, you got to do correction, boy. If it's wrong, you got to do corrections. You got to show the working. Guys, if you got wrong, please do correction. If you got wrong, please do correction. If you never do, then you will not learn. You will not do, then you will not learn. Okay, please do a correction. If I have 3z minus 1 over 2 equals to z minus 4 over 3. This is again, guys, question 3.2b. Right? When you multiply, you need to remember that you are multiplying the entire expression. So I just want to put this in front of you and show you that you are multiplying the blue and the blue. You are multiplying the green and the green entirely. Okay? So what does that give you? Are you all with me? Can I? Mulan, okay, ma? Mulan, you're doing the question. Q2C. Is your B correct? Are you successful with your B? You are? Okay, so with that, this is 3 multiplied by 3z minus 1. Tikai, what's my right hand side? When I cross multiply? 2 times, or 2z minus 8, very good. 2z. Okay, Mark, can you? You can do that when you have one fraction equals one fraction. Okay? Can I have one fraction equals one fraction? Okay? Can I? Okay. So, 9z, 3 to minus 1, that's minus 3. 2 to z, 2z, minus 8, because you have 2 to 4. So from here, 9 and 2, that gives you 7. Should I bring the 2 over to the left, or should I bring the 9 over to the right? Why? Which one? Let me ask. I thought about this just now. Let me see who is paying attention. Who's not? Let me guess. Who's not looking at me?
Magnus.
Yeah. Okay. You know, Thailand not answering. Okay. Magnus. Magnus answering. Let me ask. Who is I not ask?
Jethro.
Jethro's been looking at me all the time.
No, buddy.
Jethro gives me 100% eye contact all the time. Not like you. You are only looking at. Okay, so.
No,
okay. Let me ask. Leaving, come, give me a try. Oh, Ignatius. Do I bring 2 to the left or 9 to the right? Is it easier to bring 2 over to the left side or 9 over to the right side? To the left. Why do I do that? Yes, very good. Okay, so guys, I think you all are all thinking, okay. I will minus 2z on both sides so that I can keep 9 minus 2, I keep the positivity. Okay, so in life, we all like to remain positive. Okay, so after that, I bring the 3 over, plus 3 on both sides, negate. I plus 3 on both sides, cancel. Minus 8 plus 3 is how much? Minus 5, okay, very good. So 7z equals to minus 5, z is equals to minus 5 over 7. Okay, can I? Why you sit so close to do it? Can I just see who got C wrong? Those who got C wrong, thank you for coming forward.
Okay, not alone. Anyone
got C wrong? Yeah, Okay, cross multiplying only works when there's an equal sign in between. Is that okay? Cross multiply only works when there's equal sign. Okay, guys, you just write this down. Don't forget, cross multiply is only when there's an equal sign. So that's why for this, right, it's a bit challenging for you. Okay, so from here to here, there's some misconception. Okay, so if I want to take this, multiply by this, that's only if you can bring this guy over. There must be an equal sign between them. Okay, there must be an equal sign between them before you can do the conversion. Okay? Can I? Okay. This is correct, who did this? This is correct. Yeah. Oh. Okay, so.
What is the answer?
I'm not kidding. Read the board.
Okay,
open your eyes.
They changed it.
It's
again.
Yeah, same mistake. Hamza, this is yours, right? Yeah, so same. This one, right? The minus one. Yes, you can. Okay, the x minus 2 is not x, but they're very different. Then, this part is okay, but this part is straight away wrong. I don't know how you got this. You cannot take away the minus sign like that. Okay, you cannot take away the minus sign. Okay, so this guy is paired to this, right? You cannot suddenly say that it's paired to this one. The multiplication comes before the subtraction. Okay, ma? Can I? I think you need to be very careful of your algebra. Maybe it's good for you. Maybe you need to. Sorry? Can I come over? Okay. Yes. You can get from the new store. How do you need for? Okay. Yes. 4.1. Okay. All good now? Can I go to part 4? Sorry? Okay. So I'm going to go to 4.1 now, guys. Sorry? Okay, let me get to that. Okay. Okay, can I go on? Has everyone completed every question in 3.1 and 3.2?
Yes.
Anyone still got blank? Can you just look to your left and right? Check your friend's book around you. Check your friend's book. Okay, make sure all of them got all correct. Can Next, you got check now, you want? Oh, you got check next one. Can I show you one more time? Okay, over here. Where did I write it just now? Okay, 3.2C, okay. When you want to do something like that, right? Okay, you want, remember, to have one fraction equals to one fraction. Is that okay? before you do cross multiplying, you want to have one fraction equals to one fraction. If they are not packed together, you pack them together. Okay, ma? So before you cross multiply, what do you want to have? The question I'm going to ask, before you cross multiply, what do you want to have? Pierce. Okay, before, what else? You all see, okay. Pierce. If you are not going to answer me, then I'm going to pierce you, Okay, so, what do you want? You want? Okay, Hamza, answer me.
Yes, what do
you want? Ignatius, before you do cross multiply, you want to have? What equal sign is correct? Okay, what else? I just said just now. Come on, okay. Who can tell me what I said just now? Yes, you want one fraction equals to one fraction. Okay, ma? But you say equal sign. Come on, Magnus, are you? Okay. So after that, you take 2 multiplied by x plus 2. You take 3 multiplied by x plus 1. That gives you 3 bracket x plus 1. Is that okay? Okay. After that, expand everything to x plus 4 equals to 3x plus 3. Okay, bring the 2x over. This is x. Bring the 3 over. This is 1. Okay, then with that, do I need to answer like this? Mula, do I need to answer like this? Mula, do I need to answer like this? So how should I do that? X equals to 1, I swap place. Yes, 3 is done. They may give you a key. Key for presentation. Usually we write variable equals answer. Okay, so variable should be on the left. Can I? Okay. Pay attention now, if not, I'm going to start shipping you. Okay, whoever starts joking, you'll be the first to marry off. Okay, So next. Okay. Newton's second law.
Wait,
what's Newton's first law? I actually don't know. I'm a not very good. Yeah. Oh, it's right. Second law, I know. Third is equal and opposite. Max, you better pay attention if not I can call that. Okay. Yes. Listen, okay guys, here. 4.1. Okay. You know who Newton is?
Yeah.
Serious? Who don't know who's Newton?
The guy that invented the apple.
Abraham Lincoln. Guys, as we speak, all this are recorded on YouTube. I can't believe it. Okay, guys, listen. Okay, Newton. If you Google Newton, most of people would know Newton as a physicist or someone who do physics. But Newton is actually one of the world's 3 greatest mathematicians. Okay, because Newton discovered this thing called calculus. If you go and ask your seniors, those who study differentiation equations, the James 3 and 4 topics, there's this field called calculus. Calculus is under Newton. Okay, in Singapore, if you do engineering, applied math, computing, you will study this field of mathematics called calculus. It's under Newton. Newton was the guy who discovered this. Okay, ma'am? So Newton, there are 3 famous laws. You go and Google it. The one that came to my mind is the Newton's third law. Newton's third law is for every action there's an equal opposite reaction. Remember? So you remember this? Very, very simple. You push him, I push him, I also will push back. Okay now. It's like, you know, push off the swimmer push off the wall.
This is like karma.
Okay, next. Okay, so next. So here. The net force acting on the is F equals to ma. So F equals to ma. Now when we come to this portion, what is the formula? Let me just, can you just help me complete now? A formula, basically, it expresses a rule in algebraic terms. It makes use of variables to write instruction for performing a calculation. So that's what a formula is. Okay? So this is, that's why this is 2020. So just, please copy this part. Please copy this part. Oh, this part. Okay, okay. Who did this? Who did this? Hello? Hello? Who wrote the answers on the board? Who wrote the answers on the board? Not me, not me. Oh. Never mind. This is 2020. Please don't. Okay, can you just copy this down first? Okay. It expresses a rule in algebraic terms. It makes use of variables to write instructions. Rusha, okay? I'm sorry, raise your hand. No. Yes. Okay. Don't go and find your sister, she's too far away. Okay. Maybe next time I go and camp at the toilet to teach math lesson, I'll see you all more than nice.
What is Einstein?
Einstein, the, you know the...
Relativity.
I forgot. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Relativity. Yes, yes. What do you put? This is the light bulb. Go and Google it. Go and Google it and tell me. Yeah.
He's the president.
I thought he's the
scientist. Whoa.
Wait, why he got
assassinated? Okay, listen. Kelly, go and find out.
I thought he did science.
Okay. First president of the United States. Yeah. I think it works much better. Okay. So what's a formula? A formula basically expresses a rule in algebraic terms and it makes use of variables. So for example, y'all know the area of circle?
Yeah.
What's the area of circle?
Pi r squared.
Yes. So this is my example. In mathematics, right, we call this a formula. Fang成式. Okay, so in Chinese it's called Fang成式. Okay? Yes, it's called Fang成式. I think, is it correct? Okay, can I spell a formula? Okay, sorry. Okay. Sorry? Thank you. Okay, so I only learn Chinese after I need to chase my wife. Okay, so pi r squared. So for example, if you put r as 2, what will your a be equal to? A will be equal to pi multiplied by 2 squared, which is equal to 4 pi. And usually, I mean, just a very simple unit for area is cm squared. Okay, ma? This is what we call a formula. Means when you put in something, the rule, right, the rule gives you another value for A. That's how they are related. Okay, this is what we call a formula. You put in a value for R, you get a value for A. Okay, ma? Can I? So, a formula works something like that. When we talk about F equals to ma, force is equal to mass times acceleration. Okay, this is a science formula. If you ask a science teacher, she can tell you. Basically, it's that F equals to ma. You play sports, right? Correct? If sometimes you all play basketball, you run into each other. So, compare, you think F equals, compare, okay, let's say, Mulan, you compare maybe Ignatius run into you, he knocks you.
Exactly.
You compare me, I got you. Oh, who? When? Which one will fly further?
I will be the
one. Because M equals to?
Me.
M is what?
Mass.
What's mass? How heavy are you? Okay, so mass, okay? So the units for M, basically force. Okay, this is a formula. This is a mass. This is an acceleration. Okay, ma? Can, and the unit for mass usually is kilograms. It can be grams, it can be if you are in UK, you do the pounds for it. Okay, but acceleration is how fast you pick up speed. Okay, basically it's how fast you pick up speed. Yes. No. 5 minutes back. Okay, so if m is equal to 1000 and a equals to 0.04. So very simple, guys. If they tell you that, this one, last 5 minutes, don't go to toilet, please, yes. You want me to put your armpit on? Okay, so, that means I'm trying to tell you M is 1000 and your A is 0.04. Is that okay? So you basically just substitute your M as 1000. Your A is 0.04. It's like I'm asking you.
What?
Oh, yes, yes, sorry. This is, sorry.
0.04?
It's
0.04. It's 0.04. Hey, correct, 0.04. Oh, so this answer is wrong. Sorry. Okay, so with that, what's your force? Your force is just equals to? How much?
40.
40, yeah? Okay, very good. So it's equals to 40 newtons. Okay, where newton is the unit for force. Okay, ma? Newton is the unit for force. Just like we have units for, you know, units for area, units for volume, yes, you see?
They need
a sign
to name the unit newton.
Probably. Sorry?
One newton.
Isn't newton a person? No, newton is a unit. It's just that the design
name is after a person.
Okay, oh? Yeah. Can I?
What
is your science teacher to ask me about my math teacher? Okay, I think it's A. What about B? If F equals to MA, F is 100 Newton, and I don't need to put a unit down, and A is 0.1, right? How do I find my M? 100 divide M. This is how is M and 0.01 related? Let me ask. Okay, I don't ask here. Kelvin, M and 0.01. I asked you before on the call. Okay, I asked the most everyone. Sabina, M times 0.01. How are they times or divide? You say divide? What do you say? Times? Right. So if I want to bring this one over, what do I do?
Times.
Who said times?
Right.
Times? So if I want to bring it over, what do I do? Because we are finding the M. We are making solving for M, right? So what do I do here? I divide by 0.01 on both sides. Okay, ma? Okay, ma? So M. Sorry. I didn't see, sorry. 0.1. So 100 divided by 0.1, this will be equals to 1000. Is that okay? Can I? So with that, please help me to do the rest of part 4. Okay? Sorry?
Yeah,
thank you. And